But what if something goes wrong with the recording?
Are you sure you pressed the right button now?
I have now pushed both buttons. Everything says that it is going. So I see an ad playing.
They're panicking and picnicking in the chat.
Everybody picnic!
Oh my goodness. Late, everybody panic. It's all going wrong. Tim Kosing has broken the internet.
They're getting an ad for something.
Yes. I've had ads for things like bacon and like weird gaming flavored Mountain Dews.
You need to advertise bacon?
Wait, hold on. Gaming flavored Mountain Dews? Like, wait.
Oh, yeah. Does it
taste like dice?
That is totally a thing.
They have multiple like gamer flavors.
Oh, good.
There was one called, literally, it was called Gamer Fuel, and it was like some kind of weird mutated citrus flavor. It was Halo themed, I believe. This was several years ago at this point. So it's 7 p.m. Eastern time.
6 p.m. Pacific.
6:02 my time.
6:02 Pacific. And welcome, everybody. 6:02 Central Pacific is what I meant to say. Welcome, everybody, to Sentinels Live. Thank you for joining us around the digital tabletop while we play Sentinels of the Multiverse. The goal of these streams is to have fun. But while we're doing that, we show you how to play the game as well as cover some strategies that can help you win. We are the developers, so you can always be sure to get some insight into the process and maybe, just maybe, see some stuff before anyone else. Unfortunately, that will not be the case this evening because we're tapped out and we just launched new stuff last week. So you should be playing it. As you all know, the game includes a tutorial that covers the basic, but we always do our best to explain exactly what we're doing, when we do it, and why. And depending on how long it takes for us to win or lose, we sometimes play more than one full game in an episode. And episodes typically last somewhere between an hour and 2 hours. Sentinels of the Multiverse is currently available for iPad, Android tablets, as well as PC, Mac, and Linux via Steam, and of course, in good old-fashioned cardboard and ink. And you can always get the game, as well as more info, at sentinelsdigital.com. Good evening, John. How are you doing tonight?
I'm good. And I definitely don't want to transcribe everything you just said and take the second and fifth letter of each word and swap them around.
I was actually speaking in a really specific meter, and there's a hidden message in there. And if you do, you can find out what is coming out after Oblivion. What? No, he did not. Folks, we have two special guests this evening. One of them is Christopher, the illustrious and amazing creative mind who has written every single line of dialogue so far for the multiverse. Say hi, Christopher.
Hi, Christopher.
Hi, Christopher. And yeah. I know that you guys who are in the chat right now and watching us live on Twitch know who this gentleman is because he's been sending you on ridiculous quests for the last 2 weeks. Whether it be...
it only lasted 5 days.
That's true. It did last only 5 days.
It was meant to be an epic several month long quest, it was 5 days.
But as many people noted...
We had hoped for it to be a month or two.
Irrespective of how long it took to execute, it actually was in the planning stages for well over 6 months, probably closer to a year. Say hi to Tim Kosing, a.k.a. Peter Hayward. Say hi, Peter.
Beep, 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 beep. Beep, 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 beep.
That's high in Morse code.
Quick, decode
not,
it.
It's not high in Morse code.
You don't You're speak lying. Morse code.
I breathe Morse code.
Hello, how's it going?
So we are once again truly international this evening. I'm in Cleveland, Ohio, which is Eastern time. Christopher is coming at us from St. Louis in Central time. John, where are you again?
Valencia, España.
Indeed.
Oh man, Valencia's beautiful.
It is.
It is great. It is really nice.
And Tim Kosing, where are you coming at us from?
I'm in London.
I'm sorry. Where are you?
I'm in London, England.
I think you meant to say that you're in the London, because the London has 9 characters.
It does. London. Well done.
Yeah. Thank
quick,
you.
Quick, someone put it in the URL. See what we got.
No, so Peter and I both have this problem now where whenever we look at a small series of letters, be it a word or a couple of words or a few words, we like immediately can tell if it's 9 letters or not.
It's so infuriating when it's not. Everything should be 9 letters. You get really into
why does
that
the environment
mindset.
Have so many more letters than 9?
Someone just said everything in the chat, and I'm like, that's 10 letters. What are you doing? What is happening? However, literalis is 9 letters.
I want to be, I real quick before we go any further, I want to point out how excited I am that he said lateralis, because every time I read that, that's how I read it, lateralis. But this has been
lateralis.
This has been my gamer tag on Xbox basically since Xbox Live existed, and everyone online pronounces it lateralis, which is probably the correct pronunciation. But but I've always pronounced it as lateralis. For those of you who don't know what this is, it's actually a reference to the third, I believe it's the third, Tool album, which was spelled lateralus with a U, but they released the very first version. It's very comic booky. It was a misprint. The very first version of the album shipped with an I instead of a U, and so I chose that as my gamer tag, and it has been for...
Is it true that if you play a Tool album while you've already got one in play, you have to return one of them to your hand?
That's exactly right.
Mm-hmm. I thought so.
Precisely. You can't play unless fixed point.
There's a sick reference there, Peter.
Also on stereo.
Yes. I'm like, I know the crowd here. I can make very specific jokes and get away with it.
Yes. Yes. So Tool, people are excited that they got my reference for my gamer tag. Yes, that has been my, I've used this anywhere that you see this username. It's generally me or someone who snaked me, in which case I tend to add something to the end of it. Like Lateralis360 is actually my Steam gamer tag. I changed it here so that it would be more, more true to my true self, as it were.
This has been a fascinating tale.
Indeed. So here we are. We're going to play...
Those.
Tonight we're going to play Advance La Capitane at Rook City. And I'm actually going to sit back and let everybody else choose their hero before I dive in, because we've got guests tonight, and I'd like to see who you guys want to play.
I'm going to... Unless anyone objects, I'm going to play my favorite character in the game.
What happens if I hit the randomize button? Will it ruin everything?
Nope, it'll just randomize you. Oh, good choice.
I didn't choose it. I hit the randomize button.
I know. The randomizer made a good choice for you. And I'm going to play my new current favorite, which
good
is
choice,
Freedom 6 Unity.
But it's locked on my screen.
Yes,
yeah, so because I've never opened the video game ever.
So let's talk order. Right now we've got Fixer, Tachyon, Omnitron, and then Unity. Do we want to mess that up at all?
Seems fine to me.
All right.
I have no complaints.
So for those of you out in the chat world, obviously it would be useless for us to have two amazing guests and not utilize them. So if you have any questions for Christopher or Peter, a.k.a. Tim Kosing, feel free to shout them out in the chat. We will do our best to follow along, and they will try to answer as we play.
I will answer every third question.
I will answer one in nine questions.
Yes.
But which one?
All questions that are exactly nine letters long.
Oh, boy.
How... are you?
I am good.
No!
I'm not done yet.
Okay.
Me?
I am good. No.
Or me? I am good. There we go.
Oh, there we go. There we go.
Yeah, nailed it.
All right, so I have readied up. We can all ready up. So to answer a burning question that some people have in the chat have asked.
Ready.
That have also asked...
John, you're the only one that hasn't pushed ready.
Asked us on Twitter and other places, did we know about all of the stuff with the ARG and or Oblivion before it came out? And I'm happy to say the answer is, I did not. Handelabra knew exactly as much as we needed to know to implement the pieces that Peter asked us to implement for the ARG, and that was it.
I knew.
I knew bits... No, I knew a fair amount.
I knew a pretty high percentage, I would say.
But between the two of you, you probably knew most.
All right,
most.
One of the other things that I do real quick, as long as we're starting the game, I usually go through the opening hands of everybody, just from a strategic point of view. So Mr. Fixer is starting with a Bloody Knuckles, Harmony, Pipe Wrench, and Salvage Yard. Super Scientific Tachyon.
I was waiting for you to say Ninos.
I skipped the opening scene. I should have probably done my quote.
Ninos!
Super Scientific Tachyon starts with HUD Goggles, Lightning Reflexes, Nimble Strike, and Sucker Punch. Omnitron 10.
X.
A-K-A-X.
Omnitron X.
Yes, I always say Omnitron X. There's quite a bit of argument over, it's 10, man, last week when we were...
People can say whatever they want to, but I say Omnitron X.
I'll tell you why it's Omnitron X, because it's exactly 9 letters long.
Aha. So Omnitron X begins with a bioengineering beam, defensive blast, slip through time, and technological advancement. And Unity starts with hasty augmentation, platform bot, supply crate, and swift bot. I like that start for Unity.
there's a question there that Peter could answer, which is, what is the ARG? I've seen it referred to, but never explained.
So the ARG, ARG stands for Alternate Reality Game. This is not technically an ARG, although that's what we refer to it as internally, and everyone's called it. And that's basically this was a series of puzzles that were sent out. The first clue was in the Villains of the Multiverse rulebook. And if you solved that clue, then you got taken to another clue, which subsequently took you to another clue, and so on and so forth, until 5 days later you'd gone mad with nines swimming through your brain for the rest of your life.
Yep.
Over the course of these puzzles, a bunch of interesting story stuff was revealed, and comic covers came out, and all kinds of crazy stuff happened. But really, the highlight of the whole thing was the puzzles, which were amazing, and the rest of it was just decoration.
See, and from my opinion, the highlight of it was all of the great story stuff, and the puzzles were just roadblocks to the good stuff.
See, I'm kind of with Christopher on this one. Like, every time... John was the one that was actually...
neither Peter nor I are actually with our own viewpoints on this.
Yeah, no.
John was the one diligently following the thread, and every time something new would get posted, he'd post it to our internal chat just so I could go look at the comic book pages. Because I could
not
keep up.
Look at the puzzles?
You know what? I tried, but man, the thread was moving so fast. Some of us have to work for a living, man.
I had work to do, so I was just reading the comics, and that was pretty exciting.
I ended up taking the 3 days off to just work on the ARG and follow the thread a little bit obsessively. It was so interesting to read.
So Leo9981 has asked, when is Shattered Timeline soundtrack coming out? I'm happy to say soon.
Months from now.
No, very soon. Probably within the next week and a half or 2 weeks.
Hours.
Yeah, we're prepping it. We were actually just going through the final track titles today. So expect it to be very soon. We have to master it. Actually, I'll go ahead and let this little bit drop. So those of you who came to the listening party probably remember that Time Cataclysm was, 13 and a half minutes long? Well, guess what? It's now closer to 17 minutes long because we actually ended up launching with a version that didn't have the final little chunk that Jean-Marc wanted to put together, which the reason why he hadn't done it yet is because it includes music from an environment we haven't released yet. And so he had to actually play with some music to come up with that before putting it together. So the version of Time Cataclysm that will launch in the soundtrack will actually be close to 17 minutes. Very soon. All right, so let's choose for me here, guys, so we can...
I haven't pressed start game yet, so I don't even know what's happening.
Anytime now.
Temporal Thief.
All right.
Do we want to talk about La Capitaine at all, or are we just going to assume everyone
She's
knows?
Great.
Well, we've played her on the stream already twice, so hopefully people will know. But basically, La Capitaine is the Time Corsair. She has a name that is longer than any name.
I believe
I've
ever
that
seen. You mean to say that she has the name that sounds like Maria Elena Teresa. Dang it, I messed it up. Servana. Jimena, Mansuara, Paterna, Domenga, Gelvira, Placida, Sendina, Belita, Eufemia, Colombo, Gondina, Aldonza, Malfala, Cristina, Tegrida, Del Falcon.
And you may notice she has exactly 9 names.
That's not true.
Exactly 9 characters total in her entire names.
Lou Dolphin asks, so does that mean the Time Cataclysm music is going to keep getting updated every time a new environment is made? The answer to that is actually no. The only it matches all of the environments that are on the cards in Time Cataclysm. And the one that is included that was not already made was... Chat, any ideas?
Well, it's going to be about 15 seconds until they can even start to answer.
It is, yes.
Well, we'll let
them
happen first.
Try and catch up.
I'm going to turn these sound effects
down. Villain deck.
So out came the Temporal Thief, which takes the top card of the hero decks and puts them under La Capitaine, which is an important mechanic because if she has how many? 3 or more cards under her,
9.
Then, yes, 9. Yeah. 9 divided by 3 cards under her, she will flip. And then we have to get rid of those cards under her before we can deal damage. So the next card that came out is the Captain's Orders.
So somebody asked the chat. The questions are coming. So there's a lot of chat in the chat, and I'm actually looking at the video game more than I am at the chat right now.
Yeah.
So every so often I look over and I see something. Somebody asked, "Where is Tachyon using the computer?" Where Tachyon is using the computer room? The blade base. I see. Gaffa is responding to the blade base, which is from the thing. Okay. I thought she was asking about the art on Super Scientific Tachyon.
Yeah, but... Richard head of MDP.
Yeah, exactly. Mobile Defense Platform is the environment that does not yet have music from Jean-Marc. So that is the one that he had to spend a little bit of time cycling with before we could officially complete the music for Time Cataclysm. But he has now done so, and that is getting mastered, I believe, as we speak, and so it will be released shortly.
I see.
So this is actually my first time ever playing. Sorry, go.
No, yeah, you go ahead and explain.
This is my first time playing multiplayer. It's a very different experience. I've only played the video game solo, and I've played a lot of the video game solo.
But you have played on the tabletop with other people.
I've played it on the tabletop, I think, 3 times. Yeah, I played exclusively with Christopher, I think. Christopher, how many times have we played?
I think we've played it 3 times. I think I've played the game 3 times with you, Peter.
Yeah. Because there was the one time we just had this pop... Oh, it's me. Oh, I get to do a thing.
You should play a game.
Okay. Is there any disadvantage to just loading up on a bunch of cards right now?
I mean...
If you don't have something better to do, by all means.
Let's do that.
So I know that John's strategy for La Capitan is to try and get rid of La Paradoja Magnifica as quickly as possible.
La Paradoja
Magnifica. Because that, at the end of the villain turn, plays another card of the villain deck, which is usually not a good thing.
Yeah, they're brutal, especially against a bunch of heroes. Now, statistically, I think I'm best off revealing 2 cards of my deck, but if anyone's really keen...
Nope, it's you.
Well, depends on what you call best.
Ah, no.
Yeah, so we've actually had a number of chats about this on the stream, because... Like, yes, Tachyon statistically is the most likely to have 2 cards go into play, but the payoff from getting 2 bots into play...
That's pretty good.
...playing against Unity is usually almost worth it. And so I find that I bounce back and forth. If I have Unity and Super Scientific in the same game, I tend to go back and forth between who I experiment.
Yeah, or maybe even Omnitron.
That's true.
Could be a good play, because especially going right before him, he has lots of start of turn stuff, so... And also, yes... His base power on Unity is
boom.
Really nice.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. His base power on Unity is incredible.
I like it. Let's hit the Doha.
You should hit me for the 3rd one. Hit me.
Seriously?
No. Don't do that.
I mean, I will.
Be careful. There's gonna be times that Mr. Fixer does want to be the person hit. So
That's true.
I can get a driving mantis going.
I'm playing Masochist Tachyon.
You're playing tasochistically? No, that's no good.
People in the chat are pointing out that Christopher is pronouncing is correcting all the pronunciations.
Yeah, to point out, and I like that the person who pointed out said, not sarcastically, it's nice to hear, but for me at the same time, I'm like, oh man, I'm being kind of a jerk.
I mean, it was, I used to call, what was it? What was that Haka card that I was constantly mispronouncing? Hayeha.
Peha,
yeah. Peha. I used to say Tiana.
Oh,
which there isn't even an N in that word, but for some reason that was how I read it, and I was saying it like that until you were on the stream the last time, and I believe that was when you corrected me, and ever since then I have said it correctly.
What is the correct pronunciation of Tachyon?
No, you got it. That's it. You got it.
Okay, cool. I'm playing Super Scientific Tachyon.
Make sure to really
That's of course this evening, of course, being played by T Mikosing.
T, I'm Kosing.
Yeah, you are. We went through a lot of those.
Peter hates word.
John, what are you
doing? A thing. Just back off.
Mario Fanatic points out, he says, I could probably spend an entire day asking about pronunciations, and that's true. You'll notice that, like, we're less than, 20 minutes into this stream, and I've already been corrected at least twice.
So Skywriter asked if Omnitron U will be a new hero or variant of Omnitron X, and I said yes, which was not a useful answer to that question. Omnitron U will be a promo card. Spoilers! But we'll be revealing that pretty soon.
Oh, it's me.
But yeah.
Yeah, remember everybody out in Chatland that they do have a Kickstarter launching in like 7 days. So yeah, and expect a lot of very interesting stuff to come out during that Kickstarter. So to finish up what I was saying earlier about did we know stuff ahead of time? Here's what we knew about Oblivion before.
Actually, I'm just going to interrupt briefly because any advice on what to do here? My impulse would be to skip and then
so my question is, skipping two and skipping both and drawing two, is that better than milling the bottom of the deck?
See, I'll always mill the bottom of the deck. I love it.
I would skip play and use the power on Omnitron.
So you could rather than skipping, you could drop Sucker Punch with the idea of it gets an extra burst in the trash.
Yeah, that's what I would do for most likely.
I'm not saying that you should do that, but I'm saying that as an option. The other option is you could change. I don't know. It says that Tachyon is choosing a card to play on my screen.
You went AFK, that's why.
Why do you keep going AFK, Tim?
Yeah, so if you don't do anything in the game for more than, I think it's 30 seconds, it sets you AFK so that the game doesn't grind to a halt if the other players want to keep playing.
Just click the screen every so often, just for fun. It'll be fun.
I'm going to mill myself. I'm sorry, Omnitron X.
I don't need it. I'm fine. Everything's great.
The other thing is I currently have no cards, so this gives me a better chance of getting some cards.
Or first card in the trash.
All right, I'm going to start going through questions here.
Well, hang on. So let me just finish this. So the question was, did Handelabra know about Oblivion before it was announced? The answer is the title of the expansion.
That's true.
That's essentially what we knew.
No, we didn't even know that because we didn't know the funny spelling.
That's true. We did not know the funny spelling. We knew, like, we had heard in meetings, like, it's going to be called Oblivion. Oh. Don't tell anyone that. Yep. Shut up.
Oblivion. Yep.
Yeah, so that's that.
So let's see. Somebody asked if Level Up Leo asked if it's Omnitron U or Omnitron U. It's Omnitron U. It's a prestigious university. what is Baron Blade's name going to be in Oblivion? His name, it doesn't change based on what set he's in. Like, his name is the same in various things. The question, like, his name is still
I'll tell you why they're asking that. Because there is currently people theorizing that he's going to be a hero deck in the final set. Mm. And if he's a hero deck being played against Baron Blade, all of the cards that say Baron Blade does X are going to be ambiguous. And so people
Baron Blade's just his supervillain name. His name is still Ivan Grigori Ramanat. His name will still be Ivan Grigori Ramanat, which is the question that I'm answering.
Yes.
Okay, got it.
Okay. I appreciate your very straight-faced answer, though, Peter.
I'm being helpful.
Yeah, no, that's true. If you expect the puzzles to last a month, does that mean Kickstarter... I think I answered that earlier, didn't I? Yeah, I did. Richard, go up to the chat and I answered. I actually even specifically named you in my answer. Count Blade is not true. Vice Rip Blade. I have no interest in the material content. Can I still donate to the Kickstarter? Absolutely you can. You can donate any amount.
You can also mail money directly to me if you want to.
No, that's not going to happen. Oh, I should do things. I've been looking at the chat instead of answering.
We chose to attack the ship for you.
What if I didn't want to attack the ship?
Then you shouldn't have gone AFK.
No, that's true. That's what I get for answering questions. Environment's not doing anything right now. What do you want? You don't have any. Yeah. I'm just going to play it so you get to draw a card off of it.
Yeah, versus just
crashing
it. All right. Oh, and it's exactly the card I wanted. Fantastic. I'm so excited.
Mario Fanatic totally got the pun of Omnitron U, so that's good. It's not Oblivion, it's Oblivion. People say Oblivion really fast, but it's technically Oblivion. Let's see.
Now I have an embarrassment of riches. I'm going to play my construction pylon, but I have no idea which of these bots I want to... Let's see here. I know what John would pick, because John always picks...
Stealth bot,
yeah.
I
get two plays.
I'm very proud of you, Jeremy, that you played Swiftbot on your first turn and not Platform Bot.
Yes, I've been learning.
I would Volatile Parts as my other play.
Yeah, with Swiftbot already down to 3.
Expired Repair will let you.
Yeah, I'm going to. Actually, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to Expired Repair. Oh, I got a B-Bot. Okay.
And then you can also play Volatile Parts if you want to.
Yeah, so let's do Volatile Parts now.
You hastily augment. Me could kill the ship. Well, you're gonna get Platform Bot out there and stuff. So
yeah, so I'm gonna do I'm gonna go with what John would do. I'm gonna do Platform Bot and Stealth Bot.
Actually, we're gonna have to watch out for Maria Helena's Revenge. So we don't have any ongoing removal except for that B bot, I think.
Right. And here comes Scum and Villainy. Because that's what we needed, is more villain cards being played.
The Capitan brings out a lot of people very quickly. That's my experience with her so far. I've only played the two games, but both times I was like, oh, there are suddenly 45 cards out.
I And we haven't played her on advanced here yet in the stream, so just as a reminder on...
I believe we have, actually. Didn't we?
La Capitaine Advanced?
Oh, no, you know what? That was Dreamer. We played Dreamer regular, then Dreamer Advanced. I think you're right.
So the first time she'd be dealt damage in a round, it gets redirected to a hero.
And now she's got another Temporal Thief, which means that we've got, not only does she have four cards under her, but she's going to get another four cards under her. And people are playing, it would appear.
What are you talking about?
Peter, vote.
Peter, you have to vote.
Christopher is showing how you can actually grief in a cooperative game.
Well, guys, I just don't like cooperative games that much.
All right, is she boosting damage, or can I do send these all to the stealth bot?
I feel like the voting must have got set to unanimous by accident.
It looks like it. That wasn't me.
I think when I was showing the voting mode at the start of the game, I must have accidentally put it to unanimous. Oh, well.
So that would be him? Do you still need
this to is vote? One damage, so the or they can no, put it all to stealth bot. Peter, vote.
I did.
And you vote for the thing that we've all voted for?
Yeah, how do you vote more than I have?
Peter's not the one that has the greater than games icon. I'm the one that has the greater than icon.
Yeah, it was Christopher.
Peter has something like the greater than games color.
The voting style halfway through the game, or are we stuck with this?
No,
yeah, we're stuck with it.
Okay, well, let's just win really fast, and then we'll fix it for the next game.
Good plan.
I am playing Taecheon, the fastest woman in the West.
Good old Team Mikosing.
All right. Are we going to deal with those Maria Helenas or just get destroyed by them?
What's the Maria? Oh, here we go. So... Oh, no, those aren't good.
Yeah, I don't have any way to get rid of them, I don't believe.
Yes, you do. You have a B-bot.
Oh, right. I have the B-bot, so I can get rid of one of them. But I have to get it out first.
All right, well, I will not kill the ship.
Kill the ship!
You want us to lose?
No. I just like killing ships.
I do, too. I will knock the ship down, but I won't kill it.
Okay.
You gonna hit Bebop?
Bebop's not in play.
Oh. Well,
but you can still hit Bebop, like...
I'm gonna... get a card back for someone.
Tachyon, because I could be bust.
This is a vote.
I concur. It's unanimous.
I am vote. Oh, I have to click this and then vote. Come on. What is this?
What a world. Okay. Oh, man. I'm going to have an awesome turn. Oh, fuck. I pressed the wrong button. I mean, dang.
I mean, darn
it. Fine. You'll probably be fine with your quick insight. You'll want to play
before. Another quick insight.
Peter, I did not think it was going to be you. I thought it was going to be me. I was really confident that I was going to be the one to do that.
Okay, I think I'm going to discard that.
Don't worry. Was it last week or the week before? Jeremy just let like loose a stream of profanity when he thought he was on mute.
Well, no. So here's what happened. We had a big issue happen, and I thought that I had muted the stream, but I actually just muted the Skype. So I was like, here's the thing, guys, S-H-I-T, blah, 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 blah. And meanwhile, that was all going out live, and they weren't talking to me. And I was trying to figure out why my Skype people weren't talking to me. It was because I had muted the wrong thing.
Okay, that's great. Can you take out one of the Maria Helena's revengers? That seems like a
Maria Helena. Oh, my God, okay. I did it again. It's the worst. All right, I'm going to respond to things in the chat instead of things in the Skype.
Oh, I unlocked a variant card.
Nice work.
Congratulations.
I unlocked the variant card I'm already playing. I don't quite know how I did that.
Yeah, you put 5 in the trash.
Oh, good on me.
So to answer Josh's Sasquatch, has anyone unlocked all the Freedom 6 yet? All of the Freedom 6 have been unlocked. I don't know if any individual has unlocked all 6, but people have definitely discovered all of them.
I think there are people who have unlocked all 6.
Yeah, I agree with that. I think there are definitely people who have.
We need votes. Votes, votes, votes.
And the conditions have been discovered already for 4 of the 6.
Yes, so in fact, if you go to sentinelsdigital.com/variants.html, you will see that 4 of the 6 are posted because they've been discovered.
I think the puzzle solvers got warmed up pretty good by the ARG.
Okay, so I can stop everyone except for La Capitaine from dealing damage. So that's sort of nice.
Not with that attitude.
And who wants the card back?
Who in the chat has all six?
Right on.
It doesn't, probably doesn't matter.
It could be a bot.
Could be a bot, that's for sure.
Equipments are better because I'll be able to get them back for us.
Christopher, come vote.
Oh, right. Sorry, I'm looking at the chat again.
Hey, dang. Equipment.
Oh, I got a pushing the limits. An exciting day. It's you!
Alright.
Alright. So you don't want me to blow up a boat?
Well, we can, yeah, we can use B-Bot to get rid of it. So, I suggest...
Alright, I'm going after Chip then, unless anybody has any preferences against...
He's not dealing damage at the moment. I'd probably keep chipping away at Le Capitan's cards.
Okay.
That's true. Neither Final Breath or Chip are dealing damage, so...
So, Luckenkant asks, is the infection achievement retroactive? The answer is no.
Yeah, we have unfortunately not.
Yeah, we have not been keeping track of what games everyone has played all the way back to 2014, unfortunately.
It's also not that hard to get.
So basically, the important thing to understand about that achievement is that you need to play with one of us or someone who has. So the goal is basically that after the first round, which, you know, every single member of the Handelabra team was playing pretty diligently all weekend, infecting lots of people. So there's definitely tons of people out there who have it. So once you play with someone who has that achievement, you will also get it.
Christopher, it's your turn.
But I'm typing. Okay. No, I don't want to reset. Go away. Reset things. So here's the deal. Yep. Okay, I'm definitely... God, guys.
We're excited.
That's good. Like clicking on things.
That's fair. I do the same thing.
Oh, no. No. <Get it. laughs> You're all bad people.
Alright, I will go with the team.
Oh, there's those destructive flechettes. Those would have been useful.
Actually, I'm going to turn my options down a bit because I feel like it's animating too quickly and people aren't seeing what's happening.
Hmm.
So am I infected now? Is that what that means?
You will be.
Once we complete this game, you will be.
Oh, once you complete this game,
All right, so I get two card plays.
Here's a question for you, Handelabra team. I unlocked all of the thingy things on the iPad and then started playing on here, so I just clicked the unlock button for all of them. That means I don't get any achievements. Is there a resetting that?
No, but you can still... You just earned the achievement for Super Scientific Tachyon. Like, you can still perform the conditions.
And get the achievement that way.
Exactly, yeah.
Right.
Yeah, so congratulations. You got your first variant achievement.
I'm all over it. Actually, I've been unlocking the Freedom 6 guys as the solutions have been coming up. Cool. I love promo cards. Promo cards
are... But you don't love figuring out the solutions on your own? I thought you liked puzzles, Peter.
No, I don't like doing puzzles.
Oh, he did.
I don't like playing it.
Peter actually did help... the community solved the Absolute Zero condition.
Oh yeah, that's the one I was the most keen for, because he currently on my computer didn't have a variant. And I love Absolute Zero.
Alright, so my B-Bot is out, but it hasn't done anything yet, so I'm just going to keep going after Chip with my damage here.
As long as something will hit B-Bot before she plays a card. Or it plays another card.
Yeah, and actually, let me bring that up. So Maria Elena's Revenge... does what when we kill a villain card? Deals each hero target 3 psychic damage. Yikes.
Yeah, but the thing is, you hit the ship, and then Maria Helena hits B-Bot. Right?
Yeah.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Yeah.
So that's why we wanted to hit the ship. But hopefully something will hit something.
The Toxic Sludge is going to hit some things.
It will, but it won't kill anything.
Oh, hey. Sorry, that's me you're waiting on.
Usually. Not true.
I'm voting on stuff like an American. Do you guys normally talk politics on these streams? How about those politics, eh?
So ProFarmitage asks, how do the achievements interact with rewinding? If you have Savage Mana and Twist the Aether, attack and keep rewinding and changing damage type, does it count towards dealing damage?
We don't.
It shouldn't. I wonder. I don't know how the programming side of things have been done, but it shouldn't, because you didn't actually do all those types of damage because you canceled them out.
Yeah, there's no way for us to know that.
Yeah.
Really. It's not.
Aww, my babies. What's going on?
You're losing your things.
Yeah, I mean, the long and short of it is that achievement, if you just play Sentinels a lot, you will get that achievement. There's
exactly.
No question.
Yeah.
So you can certainly grind it if you really feel like you need to, or you could just play the game and have fun, and then you'll get it. So.
I don't think it's possible to have fun while playing Sentinels of the Multiverse. I think it's one or the other situation.
People can't tell how far they are on those achievements and stuff, and it's just like, just play the game and you'll get the achievement. You know? It'll just happen. Oh, the ship was trying to attack Bebop, but it couldn't because it had been hypersonic assaulted.
Indeed.
It's awesome.
Alright, so I'm going to hit Chip for 2, and then I'm going to get rid of Maria Elena. Oh, another one came out?
Yeah. She's in a vengeful mood.
And now Volatile Parts is going to destroy the ship, and bad things are going to happen. I would choose the ship. The ship is worse than Chip. They're similarly named, however.
Absol Zero is great.
Water doesn't matter here, does it?
No. B-Bot is going to get hit to -6.
That's good. Good healthy amount.
And this guy's going to play another card, because we let him kill B-Bot. Awesome.
No, that's going to be awesome.
It's great.
Yay.
Let's vote for battle, because I don't know what. Good. I can't use powers. I didn't need those anyways.
What would you use powers for?
Yeah. They're not
guys, we're great. We all have over 10 hit points, which means we're essentially immortal. It's great.
And she is still at full health, so
we can turn that down. Yeah,
yeah, we're fine.
Yeah, but we're getting built up. She definitely didn't just destroy all my things.
I'll give you them back.
Oh, perfect.
And actually, she didn't destroy them. The toxic sludge did.
Oh, it's me. Hello. I'm sort of watching this like I'm watching the stream, because I quite often do, and then it'll come to me and I'm like, why isn't the Tachyon player doing it?
Get it together, Tachyon.
Gonna push me some limits.
Lock and Kant mentions that some of the unlock conditions for variants have been frustrating, as they require them to play in a way that goes against all the methods they picked up from the game to win. Exactly. Yeah,
it's almost like that was the point.
Right. No, I very much like creating unlock conditions that are like, hey, you have to do something either that's like story based or counterintuitive. I mean, they're all story based, but there's something counterintuitive that happens.
Guys, I was listening to you while I played, and so I've accidentally destroyed everything. Do you want me to go back?
No, that's fine.
Half the fun is trying to figure out if we can get ourselves out of it.
Okay.
let this be a lesson into you, Peter. I have a strong preference for not using the back button. That's just me personally. I'm glad people have access to the back button.
I literally only ever use it when I actually make a real mistake. Like, not, oh, I didn't realize that card was going to do X, but more like, oh, I meant to push that card, but I put the other card. I use it for that. I almost never use it strategically. Like, oh, I didn't realize that was an unintended consequence. That's just me.
Oh, I do that all the time. That's how I live.
Well, that's the thing. As the stream knows, I am a very big proponent of dealing all the damage, all the time. And so as a result, I very often will damage something in ways that are not beneficial to the team. But I still sort of go with it, because to me, that's part of my playstyle, and that's how I just, you know, that's what I like to see.
I play this as downtime. Like, after a hard day of work, I'll sit down and do this. And so when I do something wrong and I find it frustrating, I'm just like, I'm just going to go back and I didn't do that wrong.
That's fair. Like I said, I'm fine with people having access to it. It's just,
yeah.
Well, and actually, you know, John was just telling me today that, you know, we've heard, he actually heard from somebody who said, I didn't even realize that villains had individual themes because they either used the back button or quit whenever it seemed like the game wasn't going exactly their way.
Interesting.
Which I thought was very interesting. Because to me, half the fun of this game is getting you to a place where you think it's completely untenable and then coming back to win. Like,
oh yeah, like where we are right now, we could totally win.
Yes, like I had a game I played this weekend with some new players who we were playing against. It was at least two of the people in the room, it was their first time ever playing against Iron Legacy. And the first turn went, and as we all know, if you've played against Iron Legacy, all of our heroes had lost 10 plus hit points in just his first turn, and they were all like, oh, good game. And I was like, hey guys, you never know against Iron Legacy, I think we should stick this out. One person rage quit, but we kept going, and we won with no heroes incapped, but all under 5 HP. But we still won, and that's the key, is, you know, the come-from-behind victory is the amazing thing from this game. So. All right, Unity, select a player to use a power. Did I go AFK? What's happening here? Oh, you played the card for me.
I do that sometimes.
You time-shifted me. So let's see.
Use your base power and incapacitate yourself, or you could use Modular Workbench.
Yeah, I mean, I have stuff to play. Yeah, I think I'm gonna...
Hey, if you... what's happening? Getting some butts out. Someone asked on the chat what our favorite moment was watching the ARG thread. I really enjoyed people getting furious at the 2 hour at the 80 minute Morse code video and then like an hour later solving it. People were like, oh, this is not fun, we can't do this. Oh, it's done. Like, we're on to the next clue already. That was probably my favorite moment. That real roller coaster of like, this is not fun, it's not easy to do. Like,
how could you? This is the mark of an amateur clue master.
Is there any way that with a large group of people we can automate a task? Like, yes, there is, and then people did in like three different ways. Christopher, did you have a favorite moment watching it?
I really enjoyed the by the way, I cleaned everything up on my turn. There you go, guys.
Yeah, you did. Nice work.
While you guys were busy chatting, I was solving these problems here. I really enjoyed watching people react to the story bits. Once I realized that there were other threads, I was originally just focused on the one thread of discussion. Once I realized that they had made another outside thread on the forum that was about like reacting to the story things and discussing things, that was where I had most of my focus, because seeing people's reactions to things like Ra's big moments and stuff like that were that was for me what was really exciting. So that's probably my favorite stuff.
Seeing the story moments was probably my favorite stuff as well. Like Omnitron U, honestly, that I was like, wait, what? Like that was probably my favorite moment of the whole ARG was Omnitron U.
He's gonna get a college degree? What kind of wacky sitcom Walton? Who are we waiting on? Christopher, come back.
You don't have to, apparently. Oh good, I'm AFK. Perfect. I'm trying to type a response to a really great question that I think is a longer question than I want to say out loud.
I enjoyed watching just people getting into the different clues and stuff. The usage stats for Sentinel's sidekick were at a Saturday level on a Thursday or whatever it was.
Yes.
For that little bit. Because we get a spike every Saturday of people playing Sentinels, and we see that in Sentinel sidekick, which is interesting.
Since I mentioned Ra's moment, and then Ronway in the chat also mentioned Ra's moment, I had a really interesting time writing that story. That was fantastic. And for me, a big part of when I write characters and I write their dialogue especially, I get into that character's head and I put myself in that character's shoes, and I kind of let the story just come out from what that character has had all these years of time in my mind to grow to a complete entity. And writing Ra's last words was an exciting moment for me, because I really didn't know what he was going to say. I wasn't sure where I was going to go with that. And I got there and I wrote them, and I was like, oh yeah, that's perfect. That's cool. I wouldn't have guessed that he would have said that, but that's exactly correct. So that was a a nice moment for me.
Guys, I don't think we're going to win this.
It's so nice that I almost don't want to follow it up by pointing out that they are all fans of Katy Perry in the chat.
That's fine.
You don't know that, Peter. Everything is fine.
I enjoyed writing that line, too.
So I don't know if I've actually told this story on the chat. I may have, because it would be shocking if I hadn't. But so both Peter and I are probably equivalent fans of Katy Perry, which is where my understanding of where that came from. But I actually, the night before Gen Con 2014, I was actually at the Katy Perry concert, and I dislocated my shoulder. I had to move a bunch of boxes and tear down and set up booths and stuff at Gen Con 2014 with a dislocated shoulder. And that was, I was the butt of no end of jokes from the Greater Than Games team. Because we weren't really all that close at that point. I was just this guy that was bugging them to let me make a video game of their awesome card game.
Crest, I voted.
There you go.
Do we want to destroy a bot? I can.
Kill all of our team.
I mean, not any of these bots.
We don't want to just tactically destroy a bot or anything? No, cool.
You do have the ability to damage 14 targets. It's kind of a waste to not use that ability.
Oh, yeah. There you go.
Yes, successful experiment.
We're going to do this. We're going to win it.
That's a twofer against Le Capitaine.
Yep.
So.
Christopher, you got to be ready to vote twice.
Guys, I'm trying to have a nice time with the people in the chat. We're chatting over here. I said a really funny thing. Come on.
Click on the text chat in the game and click the little away button and it'll make you AFK.
So, someone suggested I tactically destroy Mr. Fixer. Everyone draw a card. I have feeling generous.
Get a charge, a light speed. Ooh, oh, nice.
Light speed is nice.
Oh, yeah.
And you can play it.
Yeah, but...
Oh, but it won't
yeah, right, yeah, it's not useful right now. Oh, it's a bummer.
Yeah, hold on to it.
Yeah, for your next turn.
Are we going to win this?
We got this.
Just because she's over 70, that doesn't mean we haven't got this.
Christopher, you have so many cards.
I'm real good at cards.
So most people don't know this. I'm gonna break my rule and I'm gonna pre-announce something for the Kickstarter next week. Christopher's gonna kill me. The box actually comes with a bag of holding, so that you can actually take the entire collection of Sentinels of the Multiverse with you without breaking your back.
Also known as Sentinels the video game.
And a copy of Sentinels video game.
Because that's how you bring Sentinels around without breaking your back.
There you go.
I'm gonna take some turn here, guys. It'll be a minute.
Okay. You have
she
a lot
doesn't
of
have, yeah. She doesn't have any ongoing cards.
We've destroyed all of them.
I've got an ongoing. If you really need to take an ongoing out,
I don't need to take an ongoing.
She has one ongoing left in her deck. She's played them all except for one.
Yeah, that's okay.
So does that mean she has more crew about to come out, or is it all one shots?
A little bit of both. That'll be fun.
Why not?
All your bots back in your trash.
All right, there we go. All right, so what is the chat saying? Back to these people over here. Okay. Previews of the box. OPT lawyer, there will be previews of the box on the Kickstarter. Okay, and let's see. The stuff with Legacy, with the Iron Legacy. Writing the Iron Legacy stuff was also a lot of work.
So I can use all my damage to get those cards out from under her with the hope that she'll then flip back. Does that sound like a plan?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay.
Yep, I like it. Grayskull, some of the Legacy, some of the Paul Parsons did have younger siblings, but none of them had any powers.
We need two votes on this vote.
Oh, gosh darn it. Voting again. Okay.
All right.
Richard, yes.
You could take out Siegebreaker with Powered Shockwave, but it might be good to save it. I don't know.
Peter, yes, you are a Sentinel.
And somebody watches the stream back, hearing Richard yes is not helpful. You need to read what the question is.
I know. No, I'm very happy with my answer.
And Raptorbutt's going to bite one of us too.
Now, Peter, I'm going to do it even more.
No.
Peter, I am so awful because you bring out the best in me.
Oh, wait, what's happening here now?
Ooh, this is the advanced. She's on advanced,
so. Oh, the advanced. Ah.
You guys asked for this, I will point out.
Is Mr. Fixer a traitor all along? That's what I'm getting from this. Hopefully she has the second lowest HP. She doesn't. Ah.
It's almost always going to be one of Unity's here.
Voting time.
Oh, gosh darn. Thank you.
Let's get to the polls.
Voting time. Nailed it. Man, we are kicking her posterior.
In a way that she
does. You may as well destroy Fong's statue. Yeah.
We got this, guys. We got this.
Deliver it. Oh, it's her turn now. I thought that was her turn. Oh, dear. Oh, that's not too bad.
Yeah.
Voting time.
Could certainly be worse. Just going to be one single card. Actually, why don't we get rid of Slip Through Time? I guess you're not going to either Person Limits or Slip Through Time, I guess, would be fine.
No. Wait,
I'm getting rid of Pushing Limits anyway, aren't I?
Both of these are going to be destroyed.
Yeah, we're going to have to kill two, because it's him plus one, right?
Oh, right, yeah.
No, he's not. This is a one-shot. There's going to be one card destroyed.
Oh, right, it looks like Chip. And so I was doing the math. So which one are we trying to get rid of?
Limits. Go back to Pushing the Limits. All Leave right. my Slip Through Time alone.
Like that. Oh, that's me.
All right, 60 points of damage in one round. Let's do it.
We got this.
All right.
What do I want to do? Do I want charge or I want harmony?
Yeah, Lock and Can't says he loves the art for her flip side. The shifting forms works well. Thank you, but that is actually meant for Adam.
Yeah.
Adam makes the decisions about the artwork, and so you can congratulate him. I agree. I think that looks pretty awesome.
Yeah, on her flip side, she looks so cool.
Yes, she does.
Oh, and we got a Lightspeed Barrage.
Peter, it's you. Peter. Peter. Peter.
Ah, I'm on it.
Peter. Yeah. Peter. Rice.
Bam.
Is that Rice? No, Rick Restoni. Rick Restoni. It asks how the RPG is going, and the RPG is going great. It's taking a little bit of a backseat right now to Oblivion, but oh my gosh, so good.
By the way, I haven't had a chance to say this to you yet, Christopher, but can I just say the logo for Oblivion is amazing.
Isn't it gorgeous?
I saw that. I was like, oh my goodness. Especially because, like I said earlier, I knew what it was going to be called. And as of like 3 days before the announcement, I knew how it was going to be spelled. But I had no idea it was going to be that like angular and like holy crap. And I was very excited to see it. Very cool. Well played.
So failed. It's true.
Successfully destroying it.
So, Jeremy, do you know who you have to thank for that logo?
Jennifer. Yep, I figured it's
Jennifer Clausen.
Hey. Why didn't you destroy Slip Through Time?
Oh, right, yeah.
All right, great. Here we go.
It's just because I don't like you, John.
I realize that now.
Do-do-do. Do 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 do.
Evil Dice Monkey asks, "Hey Christopher, could you say my name and a random answer to confuse people watching the stream later?"
Richard, you ruined that now, haven't you?
I did. Yeah, really. I did that on purpose.
Great, thanks.
Because that's just the kind of guy I am.
I guess someone has to be the bully.
Yep. I'm the killjoy.
Death.
All right, Unity, you got this?
Yeah, let's see. Who has like a... Super awesome damage dealer.
Flash forge into another raptor bot and platform bot. Flash forge.
Yeah, so do I have, what do I have? I have
raptor and platform.
One raptor and one platform. All right, yep, I can do that. That's fine.
You are going to do a lot of damage.
Are we going to win?
Yeah.
Awesome. Okay, I'm going to close the chat because it's really, I'm not able to play this game and also chat.
You ignore the chat. I'll pay attention to the chat. I'll tell you if I have any questions for you. Okay, guys. Okay, guys, in the chat. Peter's not looking at the chat anymore. So now you can say all those things and I'll type to you about it. It's going to be great.
How did he get such a sexy accent? Guys, I can't read it. Stop saying it.
Do you feel like your accent is going to switch to English?
in the 10 days that I'm here.
In the 10 days.
So they're saying, Peter, we love you. Come back to us, Peter.
Aww.
Oh, some. So, yeah.
So what
that's
I do?
That's a pretty
8,
good turn,
16,
Jeremy.
16, 24, 28. So I did 28.
Yeah, she got 7 hit points left. We can win this.
Whatever
I told
I
you we were going
to
win this.
You did 4 from turret butt also.
So 32 damage altogether.
All right. Plunder is good.
Evil Dice Monkey asks, Handle Ever Games, what? Could you ruin another one of my jokes, please? Yes, I can.
Yeah, no, that skill is there.
Oh, yeah, I prevented her from doing damage. Go me.
delightful.
Let's destroy all of Mr. Fix the stuff. I have a suspicion, and Christopher, maybe you can back this up from a story point of view. I reckon in this game, Mr. Fixer is secretly working for Le Capitan.
Nope. That's not happening.
Well, then we'll destroy my stuff. Maybe I'm secretly working for Le Capitan. You need to vote, too.
I'm secretly working for Sharon.
Typing to the people that really like me. Oh, wait, hold on. Why are we destroying that? That was wrong. I just voted for what everybody else was voting for.
That's how we end up with Trump as president, Christopher.
Now, why aren't we voting about... No!
Fine.
I said it earlier, I'm going to repeat it. Someone said this is like watching Twitch plays Pokemon.
Hey, we've done that. We've had Twitch plays Tachyon.
How'd it go?
It went really well.
It took forever.
It did take quite a bit of time, but it was fun. We had a good time. I think the chat will back me up on that one.
Gaffa Dream says greater than tacos. I would like to point out that nothing is greater than tacos. Thank you.
Who wants a card? Everyone, go for it.
Somebody asked me from all the Sentinels fanfic, what's the worst I ever came across? I have read very little Sentinels fanfic, but I've read some great stories that a lot of our people have written and posted on the forum that I'm just now realizing that technically counts as fanfic, but it's really well done. So what do?
Should I target Tony Taurus and do nothing or La Capitan and win the game?
Yeah, I think the overkill.
No, Tony Taurus. Tony Taurus.
Omnitron.
I'm going to go to Tony Taurus.
Yeah. Oh, committed to it. Committed.
Man, commit
so,
to the
he's
bit.
So tough.
I
he's
love
so
it.
Tough. Like Tony Taurus.
You can't even hurt Tony Taurus.
Now I'm gonna kill him.
And now you're gonna kill one of my raptors.
Yeah, do it. Take this time.
Did you see the stream last week where we killed the dreamer accidentally because of volatile parts?
It sounds like you.
Yeah.
Do all the damage.
Jeremy. It was not me. It was Jeremy.
Just gonna play whatever. let's see.
You can destroy my things.
I'm destroying Bloody Knuckles.
Yeah,
but
I mean,
I'm not gonna destroy
there's an expiration date. As soon as we hit Unity's turn, there's really no way that we're not gonna up there.
We won.
Oh no, she's getting absorbed into time.
Also,
sorry,
we don't
get to hear her theme because we actually won.
Yes, indeed. Advance Le Capitan going down in just under 1 hour. Well played.
And see, I think a lot of people would, like, when we got to the point where we were like, we can still win this game, some people would have restarted because they're like, oh, I'm going to lose.
Exactly.
I never restart.
Yeah, I had a few early games that worked that way. Oh man, now you made me sad. I'm thinking about Alan Rickman.
By God's hammer.
All right, so if we go in a new game, make sure that you turn off unanimous voting so that Christopher.
Are we gonna play another one?
Yeah, if we finish the first game in under an hour, we usually play a second.
We finished the game in 1 minute over an hour.
Well, we didn't start this game until like 8:15, so.
Okay, and we started 1 minute late, also, remember, because Jeremy pressed the wrong button.
okay, we can't.